Let me hear it. See if it's on.
Mic check.
Mic check. Mic is checked. And you got, I'm trying to hear from right here. Okay, we're gonna have to come to about right here.
They don't have to say record.
No, should be recording. If you did what I told you to do on that video. What's up, you guys? You are now tuned in to the On Your Keys podcast. I'm your host, Mink, and we have my co-host right here, Mr. J. Godays,
aka Mr. On Your Keys, y'all. What's good, y'all?
What's up? We are so excited to be here. We are, like, I say that every time because it's the truth.
Definitely.
We are so excited to be here to bring you guys just another topic, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Teaching you guys, you know, holding you guys accountable, you know, just being a little
uncomfortable.
No, I was saying like being a point of refuge, clarity,
real
relief,
real,
and knowing that, you know, your shit just ain't all the way messed up. You know what I'm saying? Today we're gonna be talking about something.
Well, I ain't gonna say I'm all that too familiar with this topic that I got a real reference point, but my bae do though.
You done messed the whole thing up. We're not talking about this topic so that you can have a reference point. You don't even have to say that.
What's wrong with me saying that though? I was just making a conversation.
I felt like you were trying to be funny.
Be funny about what?
About that.
You felt some type of way that I said that?
Well, I thought you were trying to be petty.
I was at the same time, but I still
wasn't serious. I thought that you were trying to be petty.
No, I wasn't. Anyway, we talking about today when you still in love with your ex.
I wasn't still in love with my ex.
Anyway.
Let me stop chewing this gum on here. See how we just had an uncomfortable moment, y'all? See? Even on camera. It's real. See? This real estate, real life.
Like, Coco knows that it's worse and finest.
I know, right? But anyway, you guys. So the topic for today is, you can't look at this, though. You have to look at that. You have to just look at it. Like you're looking at somebody. Because you look like you're looking over there. You don't look like you're looking at the people. So, like, if you're looking at the people, that's what you're doing. You're not looking at yourself, okay? But you got to cut this part out.
No, anyway. I'm not going to cut
no,
this.
No, seriously.
I'm going to leave this part in here. What?
Come on. All right. So, anyway, you guys. So, today,
transparent, right, y'all? Ain't that what she said? Y'all heard her say it. I'm cool with it. Go ahead. Continue.
So anyway, I forgot what I was So we're talking about still having feelings for your ex. So the topic is straight point blank period is, you know, when you still love your ex.
Yeah. And you try to act like you don't. And then you get into another relationship, and then you try to act like you know that them feelings gone.
Because Mr. Petty over here, if you're not gonna have a good conversation with our supporters.
Hey, this is a great conversation, y'all. I am really having so much fun having this conversation.
But who was still in love with their ex though?
Hey, we are not here to judge. We're not here to point fingers. We're not here to do none of that. We are here to help. And we're helping you through our experience.
Lucky for you, you only have one ex, so whatever.
It just so happened that this experience...
I'm being funny. You only really had one real girlfriend.
This experience, I don't have that much experience. But, you know, I mean...
So, let me ask you a question then. Oh. So, okay, you know what? Whatever. It doesn't even matter. Anywho... So when you still have feelings for your ex, what would you say about that?
I mean, you
know. Let's break that down. When you still are in love with your ex, or, well,
so the thing is about the effects of that, you know. So, you know, we know, like, a lot of times, you know, you can get in a relationship and that relationship might not continue. You know, it doesn't mean that whatever happened, but you may still have some feelings there. Then you get into another relationship, and it doesn't mean that your new relationship is not, you know, what it is not good or anything like that. But some, you can't. One thing we know about being human beings and with dealing with emotions have to pass at a term that you allow them to.
Yeah,
you can't.
That's good.
You know, you're not, if you're not trying to move on, you ain't, and that's just point blank. You know what I'm saying? So the effects of still having those feelings, especially when you go into another relationship, they can really make or break your relationship if you allow them to. And they can continue on for years, even subconsciously, that you might not even.
Some of those cycles within the relationship, some of those bad points in the relationship, those attached attitude, mm-hmm. or, you know, ways that we attach certain things, you know, certain movements to certain ways we may feel, you know, having all that. Go ahead.
You can even adopt, like, in a negative relationship, you can even adopt behaviors from that.
Like control.
Yeah, from their old relationship and bring them into your new relationship.
I had a control issue in terms of the, so my control issue was because, what do you think my control issue was?
It was for precaution.
Yeah.
So like when me and Min got together, she was like, you know, she had some, I'm not going to really call her controlling, but she has some controlling behavior.
Yeah.
You know, but
thank you for clarifying that.
But I was able to identify that, you know, her behaviors didn't match her personality. You know what I'm saying? So it's like I could tell that just kind of when I was getting to know her and knowing the relationship that she was in before that and how long that they were together and just kind of knowing some of her story, I'm like, you know, she seemed like she kind of adopted some of this from the past relationship. And, you know, being able to see that. Her thing was she would try to control the situation to say if I control this won't happen.
So okay, so what made you so understanding though, or what? What made you so understanding? Because you know every person may not see that the control is not aligned to that person's personality. So what made you be so understanding in that situation?
Well, I'm not going to say that I just was automatically understanding. This was one of those situations that goes straight into what we talk about all the time, communication. When me and you first started getting to know each other, you trusted me with so much of your personal information, so much of your personal life, so much of your story, you know what I'm saying?
And that was because you had a very genuine spirit.
Yeah, so, you know, so she trusted me with some very, very, you know, vital information about her life, you know, early in our relationship. And when somebody's giving you something like that, giving you that part of them, giving them, you know, that part of their life, it kind of puts you in a state to where all you can really do is respect them to come out of the shell that they've been in, or whatever they've been dealing with. If you love that person, if that's something that you're looking to have and something that you're looking to nurture. So when we got together, you know, I knew I wanted to be with her. I knew I had saw myself having a future with her. And like I said earlier, some of the ways that she would act, it didn't match her personality. You know, me kind of seeing.
So let me ask you this. So the fact that my actions did not match my personality, then how did that contribute to, you know, our relationship? Or how did that contribute to your patience with me and then you staying with me?
Yeah, so good. Glad you asked that. So me being able to see that, I knew that it wasn't gonna always be that way. I knew that eventually, you know, when she was able to really heal from those wounds and then we was able to still foster our relationship, then I would really see the real her.
Yeah. And so going back to the control thing, you know, me and my ex, we got together very early on in life. You know, we were still teenagers. And so, you know, because I was growing, because I was still a teenager, he was still a teenager, basically, you know, we grew up together, you know, and some of his bad traits rubbed off on me, and I'm sure some of my bad traits rubbed off on him. And so being that we were together for so long, you know, when I did get out of the, because we were married, so when I did get out of the marriage, the reason why I still had those feelings was because of the attachment thing. You know, just I was attached to him because that was all I pretty much knew. You know, and going back to everyone has a past, everyone has a story. So being that if you know, because of my story, because of, you know, some of the things that, you know, I've been through, him being there for me was much more than just, you know, it was deeper, you know what I'm saying? It was deeper right. than a relationship type right. of thing, you right. know? So I did carry some of those feelings over, and, you know, it was toxic feelings, actually. It wasn't really, when I do talk about this, I tell people, I'll say, well, yeah, you know, I did. I loved him, but I the love that I received from him in the beginning was when we were young and we were innocent, you know. Yeah. As things progressed in our relationship, you know, it was so toxic because it was more of us being together for comfortability. Mm-hmm. So again, that's why I'm explaining this. So my toxic traits and the toxic feelings that I brought over, which again was because of all of that, I still had those feelings. You know, and because this new person, and, you know, I talked to a lot of, you know, guys, you know, during, you know, me, him and I separation. But, you know, he was the first one that really showed, like, genuine care. And that was scary for me. So then those toxic feelings that I had that I was so used to and I was so attached to, when you got something totally different, what are you going to do? It's not normal for us to attach ourselves to something that's good.
Right.
You know what I'm right. saying? So that's where a lot of those feelings came from that I carried, you know, into it, you know. And, you know, love is love, whether if it's toxic love or not, it was there. I still had those feelings, but I was honest about it.
Yeah.
That was another thing too. You know, I had talked to a lot of guys, like I said, again, you know, during that time. And so when Jay and I started to become friends, that was something that I told him, because I felt like if that's how he felt, I would have wanted to know also. So, you know, again, we always talk about communication. That was one of the biggest things, was we were always open and honest with each other. I never really felt like I ever had to check behind him or check his phones. No, I'm not gonna say I never did that, because I have, but I never really did. I never his, you know, people that were in his life before me, you know, which the one person that you know, I know that he, you know, loved, I never felt like I had to worry about them, because that was not the foundation of our relationship in the beginning. Lies, you know, right. We didn't build a foundation off of lies. We actually built a foundation off of transparency. And that's kind of like what we've kept through the relationship. That's why you guys hear us talk a lot about communication and a lot about being honest. Because if you build your relationship on honesty, then it's like you really will always have that true person. That when you have to lie about who you are and about your experiences and to try to make this person fit into the character that you want them to be, it never lines up, because you are never going to truly be who you truly are, and then you're going to be miserable, and then you're going to try to live that person outside of when you're actually with that person. And so then when you go home to that person, then you're still miserable.
You remember the first lie that I told you?
Yeah.
What it was?
How many girls you slept with?
That's yeah. another show.
Oh my God.
Y'all, talk about that story.
Yeah. Yeah. And you know, really, because why do women ask that question,
oh,
right?
Bro,
you know, that's why.
I was telling Daryl just about that, about that conversation. About
oh,
that.
Really?
Of course, he understood where I was coming from. But I was telling him about, we was talking about the growth that you, like how you are now from how you was 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, and I gave reference to that conversation, that specific conversation. I'm like, but now she see what I was trying to, the point I was trying to make 10 years ago. It's like, but she, I said, no, she couldn't get it. It's like, no matter which way I tried to explain it, it's like, she was like, that's not what her level was at that time. She wasn't, you know, she hadn't reached that level.
I was such a baby. Like, and that's why a lot of these topics, like even being, you know, still having feelings or still being in love with your ex. I don't want to say being in love. I want to say having love, because I truly feel like you cannot be in love with two people at one time. That's my opinion. You know, y'all chime in and let us know, how do y'all feel? Do you feel like you can be in love with two people, or do you feel like you can love two people? I feel like it's a difference. But you guys, let us know how you guys feel. You know, and let us know if you guys feel like, you know, bringing, you know, those toxic traits in your relationship, if it's the type of thing that, you know, is, what is it called? Like a no-go?
Oh, yeah. A deal breaker.
Yeah, deal breaker. Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, so let us know if, like, that's a deal breaker or, you know, like, let us know y'all experiences about this because, again, you know, Jay did not have that experience, but I did. I had that experience. And so, let's go a little bit further. How long did it take me to get through it? You wanna talk about that?
Yeah, what it was
like. Ask me.
How long it took you to get through it?
No, just say the whole thing. Say the whole question.
How long did it take you to get out of love with your ex?
That sounds so horrible.
I felt like that was
okay.
Really painful.
I know, right? So, how long did it take me? Okay, so let me just tell y'all. Okay, so me and Jay, we got engaged. So I got deployed, right? I got deployed and I was gone for like 7 months. Came back. And so when I came back, you know, we got engaged like months later. And when we got engaged, my ex found out that night, right? And so I had to go back to Keesler Air Force Base. And so, cause he proposed to me at my dad's birthday party. So my whole entire family was there. Oh my gosh, it makes me so emotional because it was a surprise. You know, I didn't know he was gonna propose to me that day, of course. And then it was the last ring that I had picked out. I don't have it on now. This is another ring that I have on. But yeah, so that night my ex found out. And he called me, and when he called me, I felt so bad because he was so emotional, and he could not believe that I was really engaged, right? So he was so emotional. He was screaming and crying on the phone, and so, you know, Jay knew that he was calling me or whatever, but I felt bad because I felt like I wanted to be with him because, remind you, you know, we have been together, you know, like I say, since we were teenagers. But then I had to really, on our drive back to Mississippi, you know, me and Jay, we talked about this because I truly am a good-hearted person. Like, I care just for people just in general, you know, and I wanted to, you know, basically understand, like, why did I feel like this, right? Because God knows I didn't want to be with him, you know, at all, you know. But I still felt bad because I knew how that had to feel for me to find someone and him to not find anyone because his family for the longest could not believe that I was in love with this man. I really wanted to be with him. Like, seriously, it was really crazy. But he had told me that he felt like that no matter what he did to me, all the abuse, no matter any of those things, he told me that he felt like I was supposed to always be there. Seriously. So again, maybe I believe that, you know what I'm saying? I don't know, but that was one of those times that I knew that I still had care because I didn't love him. It was just, I still care. And I did not want to feel like that, you know? And so, you know, Jay tried to explain, you know, how, you know, explain the best ways for me to be able to get through that, which one of them just was, you know, to really, really take account of like, all of those things, you know what I'm saying? Not to that you just treat someone bad, but then like, would they treat you the same? And I was like, well, no, you know, it wouldn't be the same, you know? And he was like, it's just, you know, you just can't worry about that. And so, you know, as time went on and the actions of this person just got worse over time and, you know, just things with, you know, with, they just kept just being just more and more and more things just kept coming out about this person. And you know, when someone truly shows you who they are, which I saw who this person was way before this, you really have to believe them. It really came to be that point. You know, so it was like, no matter what, it's like me having feelings for this person wasn't doing anything for me. But then it's like, I always will be like, I got someone that really loves me, that really cares about me, you know, that, you know, just admire me. Like, I used to really feel, I used to really be like, God, you know, is this real? Because he really admired me since we got together. You know, he told me, you know, it was love at first sight. I never believed in that kind of crap. But I can say, you know, but I can say that you know, honestly, it's crazy because 10 years later, you know, he still admires me. You know, we still talk about those things, but that's the thing, we talk about so much of that. So being able to really be honest with yourself about your feelings. You still have those feelings. Be honest with yourself and be honest with that person, because it may not be that you still love them. You need to understand, what are these feelings? Is it just because, is it toxic feelings? Is it just feelings because I've been comfortable all of these years? What is it? Be honest with yourself. Be honest with the person that you're with. And then y'all work through that together, because at the end of the day, you aren't perfect and your spouse is not perfect. That's right. The thing. But what's crazy is how, you know, we will sit there and we will expect one thing from our spouse. And then if the spouse was in the same boat, you know, we would have the same expectations, but it wouldn't be on the other side of the table, which is not right.
Right. That's
talked a long time.
Yeah, but that's okay. but that's correct. And,
yeah.
And, you know, and we'll, that's like a whole nother show, mm-hmm. you know, because that's a whole nother thing. But, so what's the key?
So, well, let's before we get into the key, because, you know, we talked a lot, but, you know, I really want to, you know, engage more in the conversation and talk to the, you know, audience more, like give them more, you know, pointers, like how did we work through that? Okay, we're saying that we were transparent and we were honest, but it wasn't just like, okay, this was this day and then tomorrow it changed. You right. know, like,
I mean,
how did we really get through it, you know?
It's a whole lot of in between.
Yeah.
In that, y'all, you know. And that's, and
what kept you from,
and before we jump into that, before I jump into that, you know, that's, I want to kind of make a reference to, you know, we talk about social media a lot because that is relevant to our age demographic. It's relevant to our peer group, our peers and the people that's, you know, younger than us. That, you know, social media have you thinking that everybody's life became instantly just great, right? But just like she just said, like from we telling y'all that we've overcome certain things in our marriage, certain things in our business, there's a lot of stuff that happened in between that, you know, from when it may have been bad and then it became awesome. But there was a lot of, like, you know, fillers, buffers, things in between. Mm-hmm. And you know, those are your arguments. Those are your disagreements. Those are the times of misunderstanding. Those are the times where you just don't understand what the hell she talking about.
But how you get to that part. About,
you know, so just want to lay that out there.
Yeah,
so
you, but, like, yeah.
But getting through it is, I'm going to tell you, for me personally. Me personally, getting through it was the thing I was always able to remind myself was that, do you want to be with it or you don't?
What kept you from, like, okay, in the moments where you felt frustrations, not leaving the house and going to do something that you may have regretted.
Yeah, and it was that. It was me telling myself in a black and white answer, nothing, no gray area. Do you want to be with it or you don't? Because if you leave here, or if you leave, or you do this or you do that, the chances are that you may end up not being able to be with her are very high.
Wow. And I guess that has to be heavy on the person.
Yeah, it has to be heavy on the person. You have to know, like, you got to understand what's your why. You know what I'm saying?
That's good.
And for me, again, this is personal, but this is just what I think. Your why should definitely have a high basis of love. Because if your why is the kids, if your why is the money, if your why is the way she look, if the why is because he fine, if those are the whys, All of those things can change. All of those whys can be altered. All of those whys can be varied. So the moment they change, then is your feeling gonna change? And then if your feeling changed, then your relationship has changed. So for me, the why has always had to be, I have a deep, 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 deep love for this woman, and I don't wanna be with nobody else in this world but her. And as long as I feel that way, then I'm willing to stay here and work through anything. And that was what I told myself. That was what I believed. And I believe, and I always believed that she was a great woman.
Oh, I am a great woman, period, Tom. No, but on a serious note though, that's beautiful. But, you know, I have to say that, you know, I could have contributed to the, you know, the more of the ugly side of things, right? Because all of us have flaws, you know? So that's point blank period. We all have flaws, you know? But one of the things was with us having those conversations.
Yeah, we could, not the curve, we could have been on that. Well, she said I'm cheating, so I might as well go do it.
Right.
We could have had buku of them nights.
Oh, yeah, we really could have because, I mean, both of us were, the one thing that we can say is we love each other. Like, and this was another thing. We love spending time together. So because we love spending time together, it was like the mad days are, which we try not to have mad days because anybody that knows we always are doing something, right? So like one of those days may be an experience loss.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like serious. And it's like, you know, life is too short to miss out on experiences, you know? And especially if those experiences are being had with the person that you absolutely love. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So,
I don't want to miss a second. I don't want not 1 second of my...
Yeah, he really does say
my,
that all the time.
Peace.
If I'm not happy, he's like, what can I do to make you happy right now? Because I don't want to...
I feel like that's years off my life. That's how I be feeling. I'm like,
yeah.
Nah.
But yeah, so the key here, you guys, is the transparency of, you know, of that. Really being self-aware. You know what I'm saying? Because if you lie, if you really have those feelings and you try to hide those feelings, you try to bottle those feelings up, they may come out in a way that you may not, that may not be true to how you really feel, right? But it can seem that way because you didn't have these feelings bottled up and then they just spill all over. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, you have, the first thing is just being real with yourself, acknowledging how you feel. You know what I'm saying? And then acknowledging that with your spouse. You know what I'm saying? And having that conversation or having that dialogue, you know, to where, you know, they understand how you feel, you understand how they feel, you know, and, you know, making a plan, just progressively working through it.
Right, definitely.
So those are definitely, you know, the keys to, you know, getting over those kind of things. Because not saying that it's not going to happen, not saying that you're not going to have unfinished business, you know, that's definitely, you know, leading you down the wrong path. And we were to say, oh, you're just going to be perfect or whatever. Everyone, you know, everyone has that where they may go into a relationship and compare. You see what I'm saying? So those feelings that you had, right, you know, you don't even know why you comparing this person to this next person, but you know, you still have those feelings that you haven't addressed.
Right.
You know, so you looking side eye at, you know, Mike and Mike because Mike and Mike don't look like Timothy. You know what I'm saying? Or Mike and Mike don't do it like Timothy,
oh,
you know?
Wow.
So then, you know, you looking like, I can't do it on a, I can't do, you can't be like that. You gotta love Timmy for who Timmy is, you know? And whatever Timmy, whoever ain't doing properly, y'all have that conversation. You know, don't compare to the next person because you still feel however you feel. Cause that's not gonna help anyone, you know, and it's definitely not gonna help your relationship.
Definitely not.
Yes.
Relationship over at that point.
Really?
You know what?
So yes, you guys. Thank you guys for tuning in. We will be back dropping another one. You know what I'm saying? Because this is what we do. And we just love you guys. We love the support. We love the comments. We love the reviews. We are not perfect, but we are perfectly perfect for each other. And that's just what we are trying to teach you guys, how to get that bag with your bae. Follow us on Instagram, on your keys, and on TikTok at the Godays, THAGODAYS. Go to our website, www.onyourkeys, and subscribe so that you can get these lovely newsletters so that you can really learn how to get this bag with your baby. Because I'm telling you, you know, with On Your Keys, you got health, you got wealth, and then you got a little bit of love sprinkled all in between. It's been real. Be blessed. Stay up. Because you gotta stay up until you gotta stay down until you come up.
Peace.